Henry Smith, do you agree there's a desperate need for a new runway now?
I don't think there's a need for a new runway right now, but I think Quasi's absolutely right in
You don't think there's a new need for a new runway right now?
I don't think...
Why not?
A new runway at the moment. Certainly in the Gatwick perspective, we have extra capacity at Gatwick of some 10 million throughput passengers a year that is not yet filled. There are about 35 million movements through Gatwick of passengers a year. That can grow on Department for Transport figures by another 10 million. So I think we need to concentrate on growing the business at airports like Gatwick. But that doesn't require runway expansion for the foreseeable future. But Quasi's absolutely right. The UK economy relies on our being a trading nation, and therefore a lot of that relies on aviation. And so we do need to look at the future expansion of aviation in this country. And indeed, you know, that's why I'm pleased the government last week said that they would look at the idea of a Thames Estuary Airport, and indeed also said they would look at the broader picture of airports in London and the South East.
Mm. Henry Smith, you've gone on the record as saying that we don't need to think about another runway at Gatwick until 2019, which will be the earliest time that it's possible. But what's your position given the situation that's just been outlined by Mr. Quarr, saying would you absolutely rule out a second runway at Gatwick for as long as you've got breath in your body, or is this something that you can be persuaded on?
No, I think to absolutely rule out things forever is not really a very sustainable position to have. I'm just saying that looking at the capacity that there is at airports like Gatwick still, we should be concentrating on growing the business rather than concentrating on delivering an extra runway. I think part of the issue, and Quasi is absolutely right, we are losing some business to some of our European competitors, is the fact that aviation tax in this country is the highest anywhere in the world. It's 8 times higher than any other EU country charges for aviation, and many EU countries don't charge any additional air passenger duty. So I think we need to look at our tax regime in this country in the way that aviation is attractive. And I do think that's absolutely crucial from what I was saying earlier on, this country being a trading nation.
Mm. If we had to put a runway somewhere in the southeast, a new runway, where would it be, Mr. Smith?
Well, I think that's exactly why the government is coming forward with studying this. All the airlines say that they love Heathrow, and so that would suggest that Heathrow is the place to put an additional runway. But that's something that, for the time being, the government have ruled out. That's why I think it is important that we have a study. In countries like Singapore and in Hong Kong, where they have limited land area and yet a big trading centres as well, they have managed to provide an airport offshore in a similar way to the Thames Estuary plans in a lot shorter time period than has been suggested for a Thames Estuary airport in this country. So I do think it is worth serious consideration.